Dear students, in the pollution of water, the common impurities may be classified into the three types. As I mentioned in the last session, the first is physical impurities, second is chemical impurities, and the third one is bacteriological impurities. Physical impurities may cause due to the turbidity, color, taste and odor, floating matters, unpleasant gases, radioactive substances, etc. So what is turbidity? The turbidity of water indicates the presence of colloidal matters such as fine silt and clay. In some cases, the salts of iron and manganese may impart turbidity in water. The colloidal substances and salts may be injurious to human health. Second is color. The water gets color from the discharge of some industries such as tannery, textile industry, paper industry, etc. Those discharges mainly contain the lignin, tannin and other waste products which may impart color. And the third one is taste and odor. The discharges of waste products from some industries and trades contain strong smelling chemical compounds which impart taste and odor to the water. Generally, the smelling compounds are free chlorine, hydrogen sulfide, phenol, etc. Such compounds make the water very unpleasant to consume. Next is floating matters. At many places, the dumping ground for debris or garbage may be close to the river. In rainy season, garbage are carried by rain water, appearing as floating matters in the river or stream. Again, in rainy season, different types of debris may come down with rainwater from the catchment area in hilly region. These floating matters may pollute water by decomposing. And the next is unpleasant gases. The presence of gases in water is indicated by the formation of foam in rivers. The foam may be formed by the absorption of gases while the water falls with tremendous velocity from waterfalls in hilly area, or due to whirling motion in rivers which flow with great velocity. And radioactive substances. The nuclear power plant, nuclear research center and some industries dealing with radioactive substances may discharge some waste products which may have radioactive property. This property seriously affects the human life and aquatic life. Second impurities is chemical impurity. The presence of the following the compounds as the results in the chemical impurities of water is acids, alkalis, inorganic compounds and organic compounds. Acids, waste products of some industries such as battery factory, explosives factory, etc., containing contain acids. If these waste products are directly discharged into river, then it will be harmful to the aquatic life and will destroy the self-purification property of river water. Alkalis, the waste product of some industries contain alkalis. Also, these alkalis have the same effect as that of acids. Inorganic compounds, the waste products some of some industries such as fertilizer industry, coke oven industry, etc., contain certain inorganic compounds. These compounds mainly consist of chloramines, sulfide, ammonia, etc., which are toxic to aquatic life. Organic compounds. The organic compounds may be of the organic compounds may exist in water due to the presence of fats, proteins, carbohydrates, etc. The suspended organic compound may develop due to decayed fruits, dead animals, etc. The organic compound like albuminate, ammonia is responsible for developing pathogenic bacteria, which is dangerous to public health. And the third one is bacteriological impurities. The development of pathogenic bacteria, fungi, viruses, etc. in water is caused due to the fermentation of dead bodies, and also due to the unhygienic discharge of sewage into river without proper treatment. These bacterial loads are responsible for waterborne diseases. So this is about the common impurities in water. Thank you.